253. I'm flattered.
过奖了。这个短语呢，其实前面已经讲过了，这里又出现了。我们复习一下，巩固一下，因为这个词太重要了。而且呢，我们在复习的时候用的例子不一样。我们来复习一下。Number one, 你的发音多好啊。How good your pronunciation is. How good your pronunciation is. 这里又是一个感叹句。这个感叹句呢，用的是 how, 后面加的形容词，然后再加句子的主谓语。啊，如果不是感叹句的话呢，这个句子应该是 your pronunciation is good. 你过奖了。I'm flattered. 或者是 you are flattering me.You are flattering me. 或者是 Don't flatter me. Don't flatter me.
253. I'm flattered.
Number one. How good your pronunciation is.
I'm flattered.
Number two. 你的英语在这里啊是最好的之一了。哎呀，过奖了。Your English is one of the best here. I'm flattered. One of the best, 最好的当中的一个，就相当于 one of the best speakers. You speak, as an English speaker, you are one of the best speakers, or is one of the best. Your English is one of the best here. 你的英语在这里是最好的之一。过奖了，刚才前面讲的还有 You are flattering me 或者是 Don't flatter me.
Number two, Your English is one of the best here.
I'm flattered.
Number three, 你很聪明，我非常钦佩你。过奖了，你也很聪明啊。You are very clever. I admire you very much.I'm flattered. You are clever too.
Number three. You are very clever. I admire you very much.
I'm flattered. You are clever too.
254. Clumsy. 笨手笨脚的。这个 clumsy 指行动上面做事情不利索的意思。Clumsy.两个音节 clum 再加上个 z clumsy number one 你能再教我一次吗哎，笨手笨脚的你都不知道怎么学、啊、通常一般的老师不会这么说学生的、啊、这个是熟悉的人朋友之间开玩笑说的啊。Could you teach me again clumsy you don't even know how to learn
or clumsy
Number one, could you teach me again?
Clumsy, you don't even know how to learn.
Now, you even don't know how to learn. Number two, 请带我说几句关于这个方面的好话。笨死了，你什么也不会做。Please help me to say some good words about this. Help somebody to do something. 实际上是它字面上是帮助某人做某事，实际上就带某人做某事的意思。假如说帮某人一块儿做，那就是 help somebody do something、啊。Say some good words about this, 就关于这个方面的事情，你帮我说几句好话、啊、Clumsy, you can do nothing. 或者是 you can't do anything. You can do nothing, 相当于 you can't do anything.
Number two, please help me to say some good words about this.
Clumsy, you can do nothing.
Number three, 我又把钥匙落在家里面了。笨死了，你什么都记不住。I left the keys home again. 就是把什么落在什么地方了，用 leave.过去式是 left 啊，那么因为它这个 要是落在什么地方，不是现在发生的，所以用它的过去式 left。I left the keys home again。钥匙锁在家里进不去了啊，爬窗户或者是砸门了啊。Clumsy, you can remember nothing。老是忘记事情，所以 you can remember nothing。You can't remember anything。You can't remember anything。这里用 you can remember nothing 同样的意思。
You can do nothing.
Number three. I left the keys home again.
Clumsy, you can remember nothing.
255. 你的想法应该行得通。Your idea should work. 这个地方的 work, 这里不是工作的意思。它是指事情可以行得通的意思，比如讲这个东西啊行不通的，我们说 it doesn't work 啊，它行不通，它不可能行得通。 it can't work。 Your idea should work， 你的想法应该行得通。 Number one， I didn't work out the accounts again。 我又没有算出账来。 work out accounts 就是把账目算出来的意思。这地方的 account 是名词，账目，它用了个复数，说明不止一个账目。Your idea should work。你算账的方式呢？这个想法应该是行得通的，你继续算吧，这个意思。Your idea should work。应该是鼓励的话。
Can remember nothing.
255. Your idea should work.
Number one.I didn't work out accounts again.
Your idea should work.
Number two. 我刚刚去上班，老板就骂了我一通。你的想法应该行得通。那么，这样的对话它指的什么呢？就指的，哎，你的想法可能老板不赏识，老板没有理解。实际上，你的想法应该行得通，老板不应该骂你的意思。讲的是这个意思。我们看这个句子。Just when I went to work, the boss scolded me. Just when something happened, another thing happened. 这种句子在英语当中经常见的啊。Just when I went to work, the boss scolded me. Scold 是责骂的意思，训斥的意思。一般的老板说员工，或者是家长批评孩子，老师批评学生等等，都用这个词 scold 啊，这个词很好记，就是 C-O-L-D cold 加个 S， 不多 scold 多 scold， 因为在英语里面 s 后面的清辅音要发生浊辅音 sk 要读成 sk 啊，注意这个。 Your idea should work， 这是一种鼓励的话，哎，就是老板对你的想法可能不赞赏，我觉得他应该行得通。
Number two, just when I went to work, the boss scolded me.
Your idea should work.
Number three, 你介绍给我的女孩呀，跟我说拜拜了，说再见了。你的想法应该行得通，也就是说，哎呀，你谈恋爱的那一套想法，或者是那一套做法、想法呀。正常女孩子应该是是同意你的，或者是赞赏你的，应该能相处的。哎，意思就是你继续坚持你的，你下一次应该可以跟别的女孩子处得好的，这个意思。Your idea should work。所以这个呢，也是一种鼓励的话。我们来看一下 ，The girl you presented to me said bye bye to me。这里 you presented to me 是一个定语从句，修饰前面的 girl。就是这个 present 是介绍的意思，这个词呀，如果做名词用，它是礼物的意思。present 读成 present， 作为动词是呈现、展现、拿出来看，还有介绍的意思，读成 present。present 作为动词，它的名词叫 presentation， 介绍的意思。我们这里经常学校里面让孩子做 presentation， 孩子们都说哎，做演讲，做演讲，实际上就是什么呢？你把你的一种 idea， 在站在教室面前，站在同学、站在老师面前讲给大家听，有的时候借助一些图片或者 PPT， 做 presentation， 相当于一种演讲啊。好，这个地方说你介绍给我的那个女孩 said bye bye to me， said goodbye to me， 这里面不是一般的说再见，就是指分手了啊， break up with each other 啊。 Your idea should work 啊，你的想法应该行得通啊，继续吧，以后继续来，继续谈恋爱。
Number three, the girl you presented to me said bye bye to me.
Your idea should work.
256. 你想做很蠢的事吗？ You want to do something really stupid? 你想要做 something really stupid. 这里注意，我划线的这个 really stupid 就非常蠢，它是修饰前面的 something， 就是非常蠢的事。在英语里面 something, nothing, anything 这一类的不定代词，如果用形容词修饰它的时候放在它后面，比如讲今天报纸上有没有什么有趣的东西啊， Is there anything， 所以用 anything， Is there anything interesting in the today's newspaper 啊，所以 anything interesting， interesting 修饰 anything， interesting 放后面啊。比如讲 nothing interesting 啊，用了一个不定代词 nothing， 后面用 interesting 来修饰它，没什么有趣的， nothing interesting。 好，我们来看，你想做很蠢的事吗？怎么说？ You want to do something really stupid？ 这是一个陈述句，但是呢说的时候呢，因为它是问句嘛，他没有说 Do you want to do something really stupid？ 没有加助动词，所以我们在说的时候呢带一种调子，说明是在问啊。 Number one， 我真的想跟他详细解释一下。 I really want to explain to him in detail。 Explain to somebody 是向某人解释的意思， in detail 是详细的啊，详细的。You want to do something very stupid? 你想做很蠢的事吗？意思就是你不必要解释了，一解释一糊涂啊。解释可能正好相反，恰得其反的啊，不能解释的。解释是做蠢事了。
256. Do something really stupid.
Number one, I really want to explain to him in detail.
You want to do something really stupid?
所以刚才在说的时候呢，有一个调子声调啊。You want to do something very stupid? Number two， 咱们去阻止他们的争吵吧。Let's go and stop their quarrel. Let's go and stop their quarrel. 那么口语当中有的时候这就是 and 都省掉了。Let's go stop their quarrel 啊 ，go stop their quarrel。Want to 有的时候把它合在一起是 wanna。You wanna do? You wanna do?You want to do something very stupid? 有的人呢不连就分开了说 You want to do? 也可以说快一点就变成了 wanna, You want to do?
Number two, let's go and stop their quarrel.
You want to do something really stupid?
Number three, 我真的很想跟老板解释一下。I really want to explain this to the boss. Explain something to somebody. 向某人解释某事，这里解释这个向某人叫 explain this to the boss. You want to do something really stupid? 你想做很蠢的事吗？解释不好，有的时候解释是好的，有的时候呢越解释越糊涂。
Number three.I really want to explain this to the boss.
You want to do something really stupid?
好，我们这一期的英语四百短句就讲到这里。谢谢大家的观看，也非常感谢大家的订阅、点赞和转发。Thanks for watching. Bye bye.